Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Salam, dokter.
Good day everyone. So, how are you today? Fine.
Fine, dokter.
So all of you in the campus, right? Am I right?
Yes, yeah. Doctor.
Okay. So we using the online, yeah. Is it okay, yeah? How we need the face to face? Maybe better after break, maybe we use face to face, or maybe we can use online, for online also okay, I think. Yeah, as well as you follow the instruction and then study, yeah, explore more about this course, I think it's okay. Okay. I have received your the assignment, yeah, and then I saw some of you still. Please some more, yeah, watching the video, or maybe you do not understand, please ask, yeah. So then this is important, because understanding is a better, yeah. Whatever problem or question, we will not lose the information. Okay, so let me share the slide. Now we come to the new topic regarding the bipolar junction of the PN, yeah. PN and NP, yeah. So we combine between the PN junction, and we need the two PN junction. And then we will have the simple devices. Yeah, just we have started for the what we call diode. Yeah, PN junction. Can you see the image, the slide?
Yes, doctor.
Yeah. Okay. Some of you already understood, yeah, from your assignment regarding the how to determine the minority injection carrier or minority injected carriers, yeah, in the PN junction or in the diode. So then you can get you can determine what is the minority carrier, yeah, in the PN junction. But yeah, still many of you did not understood. But please again, you're watching the recorded video, so then make you understand. Yeah. So because we will use that knowledge, we will use that information for further understanding or further explore, yeah, to make the semiconductor devices, yeah, like a transistor. Okay. Now we have a new topic, bipolar transistor. Bipolar transistor. So the idea of a transistor is like this valve. So many of you know about the valve, right? Am I right? Valve. Siapa yang tak tahu valve? Belum pernah tengok valve? Semua sudah ya?
Sudah.
Sudah.
Seperti yang ada dekat gambar figure. So then the, we have yeah, the valve is to flow the fluid, yeah, like a water. Like a water, we have a switch, yeah, or regulator, yeah, to control the flow of water, yeah, or fluid here, yeah. So in the transistor, the same, yeah, it's like a function of this valve. When the flow coming from the left here, and then to the right, and then the valve here controlled by the regulator, switch regulator here, that can open or close, yeah, and the flow of fluid here, yeah. So similarly, in the transistor, the flow of fluid here is a flow of current, a flow of electron, or flow of holes. We know about the holes and electron, right? So in the current flow, which one we consider, the flow of hole or the flow of electron? Siapa boleh jawab? Ya. Silakan jawab, salah satu, salah semua. All of you, one of you. Mana? The electric current, what's we consider, the flow of holes or the flow of electron?
Electron.
Yeah. Current, it depends on the flow of negative charge or positive charge.
Positive charge.
Huh? Positive charge. So we have a distinguish between the semiconductor and conductor, metal, metal and semiconductor. Yeah. So in metal, do you have holes? We do not have holes, right? Because all of this is a free electrons. And semiconductor, we have a holes and electron. But again, the current flow is based on the positive holes moving, the moving of holes or positive charge. Okay, moving of positive charge. Yeah. And metal also actually the positive charge. But in this case, it's actually and the metal is moving of electron equal to the moving of positive charge. But in semiconductor, we consider two charge are moving, yeah, holes or electron. Of course, the actual meaning is a hole is not moving, yeah, it's a stay in, but because of the recombination and then excitation, yeah. So the hole and electron are moving, and the hole and electron having own characteristic given the diffusion or mobility, yeah. Okay. Now we consider this one. Yeah, if we have a transistor, have a three feet, yeah, also the source of flow we call as an emitter where the behave like the source of holes here, yeah, and then collector is a collect of holes. So actually, this is the flow of holes, yeah, from emitter to collector. Then how we can control? We take the valve or the switch, regulator switch. We call as a base. So the base here to control the moving of holes from emitter to collector. Is there any flow of current? Flow of electron? Yes, it's a flow of electron is there. Yeah, the flow electron actually is a we consider as a hole as well. Yeah, the flow of electron is a flow of holes. Yeah, so this is the moving of electron actually moving at hole as well. Okay, so in the transistor, yeah, here we have a collector, yeah, as a source of the holes, and then the emitter, yeah, as acceptor, yeah, the collector collect of in this case the collect of electrons, collect of electron. Actually, collect of electron actually collect of hole as well. Yeah, but this is the similarity of valve and the transistor. Yeah, B as a base is to control the flow of electron or holes from the electron is from the collector to the emitter, but the holes are from the emitter to the collector. Okay. So, the basically of a bipolar junction a transistor is the combination between two diodes. Yeah, two diodes. Yeah. If we have two diodes here, a PN diode, and we have a PN diode, and then we join together. P is the we join P, yeah, in the middle, and the N we have a N type semiconductor, yeah. So then this is a we have a so called the NPN transistor. We have another the basic model of BJT bipolar junction transistor with the N joined together with the two diodes and it joined together, then we have a PNP transistor. Okay. So basically like this. Yeah. If we have a BJT consists of a two back-to-back PN junction. Yeah. The middle region we call as a base. Yeah. So this is usually very thin. Yeah. And the three regions are emitter, base, and collector. Now, carrier are injected or emitted into the base from the emitter. Yeah. So in this case, it's a hole. Yeah. So since the base is thin, most carrier injected into the into base diffuse into the collector. So thin base thickness means base thickness is much thinner than the diffusion length of carriers injected from the emitter. Yeah. To understand this, yeah, let's see first what is the history or the idea we use the transistor or to make like a valve. Yeah. To make like a valve. Yeah. For example, in this left illustration, yeah, in the left illustration, yeah, here. Yeah. this illustration, we have a PN, yeah, PN junction here. Okay, so this is a diode, am I right? Diode kan? So in this case, what is the bias voltage in this case? What is the bias voltage? Forward or reverse bias? Siapa boleh jawab? Saya bagi satu bonus point. Apa berarti sistem? In this PN junction, what kind of bias voltage we have? Reverse or forward bias? Siapa boleh jawab? Paham tak? Siapa tak paham?
Tak paham.
Tak paham. Okay. So I ask you to watch the video, or if you do not understand, please. So that way, if we need the understanding, so otherwise that will be difficult to us. Yeah. So we have a diode, yeah? Or PN junction. We have a P type. We have a N type of a semiconductor. Am I right? Paham ya? Yeah? Okay. And we join together, yeah. Then we'll have the depletion region. Am I right? PN. And then, if we apply voltage here, for example like this, will a current flow in the circuit? Will the current flow in the circuit? Ada current tak dalam circuit ini? Current flow or not flow? Siapa boleh jawab? Saya kena cek satu-satu. Kalau tak paham nanti susah dikit. Huh? So what, is there any current flow in the circuit? Okay, saya ulang. And P type of semiconductor. What kind of excess charge in this P type? Electron or hole?
Hole.
This is so many excess of hole because we drop with the like a boron, right? With the three. We have many excess of hole, right? So N is excess of electron, yeah, in the crystal, in the matrix, and so if we join together P and N into this one, so what happen if we join together? This is P, this is N. What happened? What is the what happened with the hole? What happened with the electron?
Diffusion.
The first the hole will diffuse to the N. Yeah. On the same time, electron will diffuse to the hole. Am I right?
Yes.
Hole and electron has the different diffusion constant, right? Which one bit bigger?
N.
N. Yeah, electron have the diffusion bigger. So then electron will be diffused far here until here. So is there any further diffusion of electron to the left? No, right? Because this already stop. There is no energy more, and then they block any electron to move here, and then hole will diffuse to the end. But the length is shorter than the diffusion of electron to this. Then what happened here? What happened? There will be different. What is that? Potensial. Kan itu di itu nanti you tengok ya in detail. Terus different potential ya. So the different potential will cause the electric field. Kan? So the electric field, this is become positive and this is negative, the electric field E. Then the electric field will cause what? The electric field will cause the attraction of electron from P, that now moving right, yeah, and a hole from N, yeah, in the depletion region here, yeah, to move back, electron to move back there. Then the why they move back? Because there is the electric field. So then the electron have mobility, yeah, and the hole also have mobility. Kan? Paham ya? Now, to function this junction to for the application, so we need the external source, yeah, the external source, yeah. So the external source is needed in order to function this device if we want to apply PN junction as a diode later, right? So we need the external source forward to produce the, what is that? Injection carrier. So then in order to make a flow here, to make flow current, yeah, so we consider about the moving of a hole also. This is actually moving of electron as well in the circuit, yeah, moving of electron. Paham tak dalam hal ini?
Paham
ya. Nah, so this is the FV, the external energy to add the additional or to inject carrier to the PN junction ini in order to work to this function of what? Function to flow the current, yeah, in the circuit. And then on the other hand, if we have the different polarity, for example this one, so in this case, yeah, in this case, this is P, this is N, yeah, electron at the N junction will be attracted to the positive here, yeah, and this is positive, this is negative, yeah, attracted. So then they will not having the flow here, so the depletion region will be higher. Okay, but this is, there is no current flow, kan? Paham tak dalam hal ini? Halo, siapa yang tak paham? Paham tak? Saya kena apa? Tanya nanti kalau tak susah. Siapa yang tak paham? So this is the polarity different, am I right?
Yes.
So the polarity different. In this case, we push P here. Yeah. So then there is flow the current. Yeah. In this circuit, the PN junction, there is a flow of current. Yeah. This is, there is the flow of current because, yeah, by injected the coal here, so they will have the recombination, yeah, or will be narrowing depletion region, narrowing depletion region, and then after that there is the coal injected. One enter already, this already there is no depletion region, so the hole will be full, yeah, and then comes out here to the negative terminal, yeah, as well as electron also will move here and recombine in the hole, yeah. Terus berlangsung sampai baterai habis, sampai energi hole or electron recombine, yeah, out, yeah. Actually electron will moving and then recombine with hole here and then stop. So there is the current flow here. Even we only with the small the energy, a small voltage applied here, so they will flow the current. Yeah. Ini kan VI. Yeah, increase will increase the current. Paham ya ini? So in this case we call as a we apply the forward. In this case, we change the polarity, the change polarity, and then we will the attract the electron here, attract the hole to the left. Okay, and then what happened? So ini saya besar terus, besarkan terus apa tadi? Ya dia sampai sini terus sampai besar, betul? Am I right? Depletion region is becoming bigger and bigger. Okay. And then what happened if we already depletion region in this? And then if that happened here, then the current flow. So then we call as a breakdown, kan? So from the last class, am I right? So during this increasing the depletion region, yeah, there is no current flow here. So this there is no current flow, but only small current flow in the reverse. Yeah, we call this is as a reverse bias. Yeah, so the reverse bias, so there will be a small current. Yeah, and this because of the apa thermally vibration, of the thermally vibration. Yeah, electron. So electron coming from where? Electron coming from the siapa? Paham? Yeah. So this in this case, yeah, the first breakdown is we call as a when the current flow here, yeah, because of the depletion region already, yeah, to the end of the both P or N, yeah, semiconductor, and then they will flow the current, yeah, flow the current, yeah, but further increase, yeah, further increase, then the additional current will significantly increase because of the thermally vibration of the semiconductor, and then goes to the conduction band and then flow the current, additional current, yeah, in this case. So this is we call as a avalanche breakdown, yeah, avalanche breakdown, so meaning that will burn this diode. Yeah, so that we have two kind of function of the diode here, as to flow the current, yeah, in the normal condition, and to stop the current. Okay, but in this case, in the reverse bias, can we flow the current here? We can flow the current if, well, if the additional electrons, additional electron from the valence band will go, or if the depletion region already weak, and then allow the current or the electron moving in the circuit, then this is called as a breakdown. Paham? Ada pertanyaan?
Tidak. Yeah.
Okay, ya. Now we move on. Yeah. In this case, this is the illustration. Yeah. Illustration when we have a PN junction. Yeah. And then we apply the voltage like this one. So what kind of bias voltage apply in this case? What is the bias voltage of this? Reverse or forward bias? We have a P to the negative terminal and N to the positive terminal. Bias or forward or reverse bias? Brother? What kind of bias voltage we apply in this case? Huh? Paham tak ini? Kalau tak paham saya ulang cuma. Kalau tak boleh jawab nanti susah. What kind of bias voltage applied to the PN junction in this case? When forward. Are you sure? If we keep this is positive terminal, we connect to the N type, then what happen? Is there any what happened with the depletion region? What happened? This is N is excess of electron, am I right?
Decrease.
Yes, brother. Yes, brother.
Depletion region decrease. No.
Yeah, I mean, my question is what kind of bias voltage we apply to this PN junction?
Forward, is it? No.
Reverse or forward bias?
Forward. No.
Forward. If forward, meaning that we flow of current, right? Am I right? So again, if we apply the we connect the positive terminal of battery to the N. So what happened in this case? Then the electron will attract it to this, right? This positive, this is negative. The positive negative will attract each other, right? Am I right?
Depletion region.
And then this depletion region will be narrower or wider?
Wider.
So if depletion region become wider, is there any flow of current in this PN junction or in this junction?
Small amount
because of what? Thermally vibration. So actually this not answer my what my question 100%. This is you just smally because of the thermal vibration, but actually in common sense, if we apply such kind of this bias voltage, so there is no current flow here, understand, or small, and that is a complete answer. So in this case, what kind of voltage bias we apply?
Reverse bias.
Reverse bias. Is there any current flow at the junction here, in the PN junction? Ada tak?
No or small.
That is correct answer. Understand? Okay, yang lain juga paham tak yang lain? Yang lain paham tak? Nanti tak paham susah loh.
Paham.
Paham ya? So this is reverse, reverse. Yeah. So PN junction here is applied reverse bias voltage. Okay. Is there any current? No current. Ya kan? No current. So the illustration we have, this is RL. RL was it? Load. We have a load here. Okay. If this load is this one, apa ini? Apa ini? What is this?
Resistor.
Ini gambar ini gambar apa?
Bulb.
Bulb. Itu as a load, okay? So in this case, if RL is a bulb, is a bulb light on or not? The bulb is on or not?
No.
No, because we apply this as a reverse bias, okay? Okay, yeah. If we apply polarity dip, the polarity here, we make the and the forward. Is there any flow current here? Ada. So the bulb is on. Paham? Okay, yeah. So that's why this PN junction function as a diode, as a switch. We can switch on if we apply the polarity is forward. And we off this bulb if the polarity we keep the reverse bias into this junction. Paham ya semua? Okay. Now my question. We want to make this reverse bias ya to the junction ya, to on this lamp. You said just now that in the reverse bias there is this small cell, there is small current, so this is maybe is not so strong the light, yeah. The brightness is maybe redup lah, yeah. So then we want this to on a brightness is more bright, meaning that we want to make the current a little bigger than the small one. Paham tak? From this, then how can we make this one? How can we make this one? Of course, frankly speaking, we should add the number of electron, right? We should add the add the number of electron, free electron, of course. Okay. Yeah. So how can we add this free electron? From where we should add the free electron? If we add the reverse bias, because the electron electron source is the negative here, right? In the negative battery. But negative battery will attract hole from the semiconductor, P semiconductor. And then the resource of hole here from the battery, but resource of hole of battery attract the electron from n-type. So then there is no current flow in the junction, only the small amount. Yeah, in the illustration, this VI, so only this one. So this is not so strong, maybe there is the bulb is on, but not so bright because of the vibration, because of the applying the voltage here, because we apply the electric field here. Now, how can we should add the electron here in this semiconductor? Right? We should add the excess of electron here. The excess electron where? The source of the excess, the source of the electron. Dari mana elektron itu kita boleh dapatkan di dalam semiconductor? karena elektron di dalam di baterai ini sudah dipakai untuk attract hole, ya. Positifnya di attract untuk excess electron, ya. Already exist in the n-type semiconductor. Now we should add the electron to excess of electron in the semiconductor to make the additional current, ya, to make the additional current. So now my question, where's the electron we should get from the semiconductor? From where? Siapa boleh jawab, saya bagi dua bonus point. Dari mana? Tak ada yang tahu. So we have the band diagram of the semiconductor. Am I right? Sini apa? Valence band. This is conduction band. Am I right? If we have a n-type, so we have what kind of doping, donor or acceptor? Donor or acceptor in n-type?
Acceptor.
N is excess of electron, so we add the donor. Donor is close to the conduction band because there's an electron here, right? Clear? Okay, yeah, brother. Apa? Yes. So this is for part of the. If you answer wrongly, you can get the 0.5 mark, 0.5 per point. Okay, you add, no problem. Yeah. So we have a excess of electron coming from the donor impurity atom or donor dopant atom, like a phosphorus. Am I right? So we have an excess of electron. So if we only have this one, the electron here attracted to the positive terminal, right? In order to have more excess of electron, so where is the source of the electron in this semiconductor? From where? From? Saya bagi dua, saya tambah tiga sekarang. Tiga bonus point, berapa? From where we get the excess of electron? Or from where we should add the electron? From where? Come on. Before that, okay. What is the, we call as a valence band? Or in other word we call as a HOMO, yeah, HOMO. HOMO, this is LUMO. We have done the experiment, right? Highest yeah, occupied molecular orbit. Occupied of what? Yeah, occupied of? Come on. Occupied of a electron. Valence band or HOMO is the band with a full of electrons, yeah, and full of electron. And here empty of electron. If this excess electron from donor impurity atom already left and attracted by this positive terminal baterai, brother, sini positive terminal baterai will attract the electron, yeah. Electron from this will be attracted and then no more electron here, so that why there is no current flow here, because electron will be attracted to this or all of in this region, yeah. So there is no flow of electron, there is no hole moving here or electron moving to the P and then go to the N and then go to the positive terminal. If there is electron moving from this battery to the positive battery, so that there is the flow of current in the circuit, or flow of electron in the circuit. Yeah. So if we do not have more electron from the donor impurity atom, so the source of electron that we can use is coming from the valence band. Karena sini banyak elektron kan, betul?
Kan? Betul betul.
Nah, so this electron is source of the electron. So how can we make it electron moving to this? If we energize the semiconductor with the energy bigger with the energy band gap of silicon 1.1 electron volt, for example. Am I right? So if you apply the energy more than 1.1, then you can promote the electron from the valence band to the conduction band. Then what happened? So then you have the additional electron here. Yeah, here, additional electron. Here also, in the P, because of a P is here, right? We have a boron impurity atom, for example, one. And then electron from the valence band already come here. Right? And the, because attracted by the negative electrons. Then there's no more electron to the conduction band. Then how can, again, we should get the energy from the external, yeah, they're more than Eg. Am I right? Okay. And then in the system here, yeah, in the system here, we have the additional hole, additional electron. Yeah, because there's a, if you apply the energy more than band gap energy, so then you can promote electron and you create electron hole pair. You create hole one and you create electron one. Am I right? Where? In all area here. You can make in the all area here. If you can keep the energy. Paham sampai sini?
Paham.
Paham ya? Okay ya. So you can follow little by little, so to make you understand. Yeah. So then after that, yeah. After that, so how can we make this one? To make this energizing of electron from the valence band? How? Remember, we make a general breakdown. We can make a avalanche breakdown. Am I right? Saya pembesar sini, pembesar bu. Nah, breakdown lah. Karena vibration kan, vibration of atom will excite the electron. Am I right? So then there will be current flow in the circuit. Okay, yeah. But this is not what we do not want, yeah, for the application. Yeah, of course, the application, there is the application for limiting the voltage, yeah, in the general diode. Yeah, general diode is for limiting the voltage. Okay, that one for the application. But now we want to make another application for the bipolar junction transistor, or to make a transistor, or make for the electronic device. Okay, then how can we make this one? Yeah, instead of we maintain the voltage here, we do not increase the voltage until breakdown. No, yeah, macam gini, macam gini. Ini tidak, kita tidak buat ini. Yeah, but how can we make the in the reverse bias the the current from this to this one, to this one? We should give the additional electron, yeah, in the silicon matrix, yeah, in the silicon material, yeah, can be in P or N. How? Yeah, this one from the valence band. Then how can we? How can we? Of course, with the increasing the voltage, they will vibrate. The vibration, they will exit the electron. Another way is to using the, yeah, we irradiate with the photon, for example, with the lamp, or we heat by heating, yeah, This is, for example, we hit here. We hit the semiconductor. What happened? There will be additional of a current, yeah, flow. Additional electron will exist, and then the electron will be attracted, here. So the electron will go here, because we have the electric field here, yeah. So the electron will go here after hole from here to this one. So in the circuit we have the flow of current or flow of electron, and we increase this in reverse bias, yeah, in reverse bias. In reverse bias, we can increase the current here. Yeah, current from this one the small, and then we can increase since we dependence of the external here from the heating or from the irradiation, for example. Yeah, you take the infrared, for example, or you take the UV ultraviolet, for example, with the high energy. Or we can heat, for example. So then we can increase the number of electron, yeah, in the free electron. I mean, yeah, yeah, in the conduction band. So then the flow of current of flow. Paham? Paham ya?
Yes.
Okay. So understand. And now, to make this one function, actually we should not energize all the time using the external, like heat, like heating, or like the ultraviolet light, or another photon, yeah, irradiation. We should not use that one, but we want to have the injection of electron or injection of voltage. Yeah, it is reverse bias. Yeah, in the reverse bias, reverse bias p-n junction. Yeah, we can inject the hole here, and then the flow current. Yeah, the flow current here happen without irradiation, without heating. Yeah, to the semiconductor, but we make the injection of hole. So electrically, so we can by applying the voltage here, yeah, by applying the voltage with a certain combination letter that we need to construct. In this case, yeah, at the p-n junction only, we cannot inject the injection of a hole or electron by this one, by this external, yeah, external using the heat or using heat or irradiation, yeah, with the photon. So we need the electrically hole injector. So then by injecting the hole here, so we can make the flow current and reverse bias p-n junction. Yeah. Paham ya, brother sister? Now we have a transistor like a valve tadi. Bagaimana? So we can inject like this one. So we can inject a hole here, or in other word, we can open the base here so that the valve will be for example, will flow the current. Yeah, small. If we increase, and then we can increase the base here, and then we can increase the number of water flow or the number of current flow here. Yeah. So in this case, so we apply, yeah, in the middle, in the N or P, yeah, in the middle as a base with the bias voltage here to control. Yeah. To make the current flow, yeah, to the electron flow, yeah, from base to the emitter, or current flow, yeah, from the emitter to collector, yeah, or collector to emitter. If we using the hole injection. Okay, the hole injection here, so the current can flow, yeah, or electron can flow from the collector to emitter, or current flow from the emitter to collector, yeah, because the EC is based on the hole moving. So in this case, the E is the source of a hole, and collector and collect the holes. Yeah. So if this happen, so current flow. Yeah. So without any current flow here, without any additional injection of hole here, so the current will not flow. Yeah. So the transistor, yeah, behave like a switch as well. Like the switch as well. Yeah. So if there is no injection, B is a potential, we have a zero, then there is no current flow, yeah, in the CE. Yeah. If we increase, and then we can. So this is the basic idea of a transistor. So the example of external control of current through a junction by optical generation raises an increasing question. Is it possible to inject minority carrier into the neighborhood of the junction electrically instead of optically? Optically, just now, yeah, we use the, for example, ultraviolet, yeah, light, or photon light, yeah, or infrared light. Yeah. Is it possible electrically, yeah, make the hole injection? So convention hole injection device is a forward bias PN junction. Yeah, convenient hole injection device is a forward bias PN junction. Remember that the forward bias is a PN junction, so we can flow the current. Yeah? But we have a positive here is the additional type of holes, yeah, in the P, yeah, or we have the injected holes in the P, yeah, so this positive, yeah, compared to the original P is the less positive, yeah, so then we have a less hole, yeah, compared to the P positive here, yeah, means the excess of hole is more than, yeah, original P. The current in such junction is due primarily to holes injected from the P positive region into the N material. If we make the N side of the forward bias junction the same as the N side of the reverse bias junction, the result the P positive and P structure. So this is the illustration. Yeah, how we make the configuration of P and P. So now, yeah, from this we have a PNP, yeah, PNP junction, yeah. We have a PNP. So if we apply the voltage bias in the P positive N, we can make this as a forward bias. Yeah, in this case, we have a forward bias from P positive, yeah, meaning that the more excess of hole here, yeah, to the N, yeah, to the N. So how can we make the hole more than the original? Of course, we will drop more, yeah, and we drop using the boron, so we will having the more, yeah. For example, P positive drop with the 15 boron, for example. This is only 10, so this is mean more holes than the other p type, yeah, oxide type. So in the p positive end, we apply the forward bias, yeah, forward bias, yeah. So the positive terminal to the p and n terminal with the negative terminal of battery. So in this case, we have the forward bias, yeah, forward bias here. So then, if the forward bias, Yeah. So we can make the current flow here, right? Am I right? So in other word, yeah, in other word, we inject the hole in P positive here. Yeah. And we have a inject the hole here, yeah, from the positive battery. Yeah. So the hole will having the diffusion, right? The hole will move here, yeah, with the, because we have the electric field in this p-n junction. So the hole from the terminal E here, they will moving, right? Bentar ya, saya. So if we have a combination between P and P, yeah. So we have a, this, yeah. So the illustration, and this is we have a and we have a P, we have a P. This is P positive, yeah. That the excess of hole more than P. This one, okay. So we have a depletion region right here, depletion region, and this is a depletion region also. But first, this one first, yeah. So the first, we make this is a forward bias. We have a forward bias, so like this one. So this is as E terminal, and this is as a C as a collector, yeah, as a collector. So. We have this is as a base, as a base, yeah. Okay, and then the on the other hand, we have the reverse bias. Reverse bias is this one. So we connect with this is positive, and this with the n type, this is positive, right? So they will we have like a reverse bias. Yeah. The purpose, yeah, the purpose of injection, yeah, injection holes here, yeah, is to make a current flow, yeah, in this, yeah. For example, this is IC, yeah, you see current flow in this, yeah, current flow. So usually we have this is a resistance, yeah, or load here. What can be bulb, yeah, or can be a fan, or can be motor, whatever, yeah, or sound system. And we have this is a variable resistor, yeah, to make a B. This is also variable, yeah, can be the variable of the injected of hole. Okay, so if we apply this, yeah, we have this is N, yeah, in the N, yeah, and the P, yeah, of course, this also we have depletion region here. So this is N, and this is a P and P positive. So when we apply in this EB, yeah, EB with the this polarity, meaning that we apply as a forward bias. This is a forward bias, and this is a we have a reverse bias. Reverse bias. Just now, we want to have the reverse bias with the reverse bias with the many current. Am I right? But normally, reverse bias here will not flow the current. Yeah, in this region will not flow the current because we have applied the reverse bias. But to increase this, yeah, current in the reverse bias, we should have the injection of hole, yeah, hole injection. The hole injection coming from where? hole injection coming from this PN forward bias, PN junction and forward bias. We should have the hole here. We should have the additional hole here. Yeah, we have should have the additional hole here. So how can we make this hole? We make the new source of hole using the forward bias. Using the forward bias here, yeah, we increase the voltage and then we inject hole here. Yeah, and the many hole here, and then the hole will diffuse. Yeah, the hole here will diffuse, moving where? Moving in that direction. Yeah, moving direction, that direction. Of course, because this is a closed circuit here, the hole also can move here. Yeah, to the base. Yeah, the hole can move to the base. Yeah, and mostly, yeah, the hole have a diffusion. Of course, the diffusion hole have a, we have the diffusion length. Remember, diffusion length is a diffusion length. Yeah, the length where the hole can diffuse. Yeah, for example, if we have this, yeah. Yeah, for example, this is PN. Yeah, we have a like this one, MRAD. So the hole injected here will diffuse, right? Diffuse. Yeah. So this is the diffusion length of hole, LP. Yeah. On the other hand, diffusion length of electron also. But we consider now with the hole, yeah, because the electric current will consider as hole moving. Okay. Now this diffusion length hole have a diffusion length. Of course, the diffusion length in silicon and germanium different with gallium arsenide will different in diffusion length. Okay. So this diffusion hole moving through the diffusion length. Diffusion length happen because the hole has the diffusivity in the certain material. In silicon or in germanium have the different diffusion diffusivity of the holes. Yeah, the value. So, if electron coming into the this another P here at the C, yeah, collector, yeah. Okay. So this is what we want. Yeah. So the electron can come into the to the hole here, to the C region here, to the collector. Then there is the additional hole here. So the additional hole will move electron, there is the current flow here, current flow in the C, yeah, here. The current flow is C. And then how big this one, IC, yeah, can have, yeah, how big, of course, depends on the number of injection hole from the emitter. Yeah, injection hole from the emitter. So then the number of holes into the C here as the additional charge carrier. Yeah, is charge carrier. Yeah, additional charge carrier. So then make flow in this reverse bias. Of course, this is a load. Load here. Yeah. Can be just no apa lamp kan, so the this bulb, yeah, can light on, yeah, with increasing the current, then the light will be more bright. Yeah. So how can we control this one? Using the controlling the injection of hole from the bias voltage applied to the PN junction in this P and E here. Paham sekarang kan? So the, we can inject hole electrically. It's not optically. Yeah, optically we use the ultraviolet, or we heating, yeah, or using the infrared or the other energy from the external, ada radioactive wave, for example. Yeah, paham? Dari sampai sini paham tak? Siapa yang tak paham? Ada pertanyaan? Any question?
No, dokter.
Okay, ya, paham ya? Okay, yeah. Paham ya? Okay. Okay. So, then my question is, yeah, whole has the diffusivity, right? Okay. Okay. Whole have the diffusivity, and then a whole can move because of diffusivity. The whole have the diffusion length. Am I right? Okay. So, if this happen, yeah, if this the case, yeah, given, so what is the requirement of this construction? Yeah. Saya gambar lagi ya. This is a N. This is a P. Yeah, yeah. P positive. Yeah, additional hole. Yeah. So, if we have a hole here, injection hole from here, a hole. So, how can we make this hole? We want to come to the another piece. Am I right? Am I right? For example, the diffusion length of this hole is like this one. The diffusion length. LP, yeah. LP, am I right? So, if this LP, saya kena gambar lagi ya, biar you paham. Lagi. Ya, like this. This is A, this is B, this is B. So if we have a diffusion length like this one, this is a diffusion length of holes. Dalam hal ini, can hole come to the P side? This we injected hole from the P side, from the emitter here, with the diffusion length at this LP like this one. Can we make this injected holes to the P, to the C? Can we have the additional hole in the P side here? My question. Can or not? Or cannot, brother sister. Is it clear my question? Is it clear, brother sister? Hello.
Yes, clear.
Clear. If I have this LP, yeah, in this semiconductor, kan sama semiconductor, different N and P because different N. Dopant, right? Dopant impurity atom. Yeah. Now, if the LP here, can we make this one, the hole move here from this emitter? Kan hole masuk dari sini kan? Masuk. Then they come to this and then go here. So in this case. Is it the hole coming to the P side? Is it the hole coming to the for the additional hole in this side? Can or cannot?
Cannot.
Cannot. Correct. Then how can we make this one? The holes can come into the C because we want to additional current here because we want to have a red. This current red. Additional current in C because we have a load here. We have a load here. If not, then we cannot on this load. We cannot energize the load, right? So can we make this one? If you say that cannot, Yeah, of course, this cannot. Then how can we make this one? How can we design the transistor here? If the LP already different, like this one, what should we make diffusion as a diffusivity as a constant? LP is constant. Then how can we make this happen? Siapa boleh saya bagi 5 bonus point? Siapa boleh buat? Siapa boleh answer? Brother? Boleh tak? It is logic. If we have the LP here, this length, yeah, then how can we make additional P here? What should we do? Halo? Tak paham? Tak boleh answer?
Tak boleh.
Tak boleh jawab.
Nah, tak boleh jawab. Sekarang saya bagi clue ya. Okay. The diffusion length depends on the geometry of the semiconductor. Depends on the geometry of semiconductor. So how can we make the diffusivity of the hole coming in here with this length, with this design? This design cannot flow. But new design, for example, what should we do? What should we do? With the length. So we have for this length. Sama kan ini? This is LP. Am I right?
Yes.
That at the end of this LP should be which region? Which region?
P region.
We should be in which region? In P and or P positive?
P positive.
This N, the arrow, this N, the hole moving right from this to that one. So this should be in what region here?
N.
Should be N. This is new design, brother. If you got to add that, this P, there is no additional P here. This should be N. P region here. If this is P region, if this is same, the emitter to C is same, then we should make N should be
smaller,
should be thin as possible. Paham? If you make this N with this N, this is a W, and a new design. So this will be this is the thinner as possible. If this thinner as possible, so the hole here can come to the P. If you add more hole, so then you can make a additional or injected hole here. If you can make a injected hole here, so you can make a more current here, IC, that you want. Then the increasing the IC depends on what? Depends on the injection of hole here. Coming from where? Coming from the B, from the just now. From the forward bias in the PN junction. But the LP here as a the length of your whole diffusion is a constant, because of the diffusivity at a certain semiconductor is a constant. So then we should design the N here in the middle should be thinner as possible. Be small as possible. nipis, sehingga apa? The whole injection can come into the pee. By increasing this voltage, then you inject many hole here, many hole. So then will come here, and then will increase the IC. Okay. So this is what we call as the electrically we can inject the hole. Yeah, using the this one forward bias in the PN junction in the transistor. Yep, bipolar junction transistor. Bipolar meaning we have two, yeah, PN and P, right? So this is the idea of what how we make the like a valve, yeah, in this for the current. So then we can control the injection current here, and then we can control the current, yeah, in the IC, yeah. Or in other word, yeah, in the reverse bias here, in the reverse bias just now, this is P reverse bias like this one, yeah. Reverse bias, we can have the current flow here, yeah, by additional of the electrically injection injected the holes from emitter. Okay, jelas, brother, sister. Okay, okay, tak okay. Ada yang pertanyaan? This is the basic idea of the transistor, and then we are going to in more detail, yeah, in more detail. So yeah, we can make the end region narrow as possible compared to the whole diffusion line, so that the hole can come to the P collector. To the collector, so there will be a current flow in this case. Yeah. Okay. Okay, brother, sister.
Okay.
Yeah. Now we analyze in more detail. Yeah. We analyze in more detail. Yeah. Yeah. Ini sudah saya sudah jelaskan. Yeah. So in more detail. Yeah. Let's see. This is a collector. This is a base, and this is a emitter. Yeah. And the we have here forward bias in the emitter. Yeah, we have here reverse bias from the collector. Okay. Now. Let's see. If we apply voltage, yeah, in the here, we apply voltage, meaning that we inject the hole here. We inject the hole here, and then hole moving there. Okay. At the same time, yeah, if we apply voltage here, we inject hole, and we, in the same time we supply the electron. We supply the electron from base, yeah. We supply the electron base, yeah, to the end, because base is connected to the end, yeah, semiconductor. Okay, so the electron from the base will come to the end here, yeah. At the same time, the electron, some of the electron will go to the P positive, yeah, P of the more excess of force, yeah. Because why? Because we apply the voltage here, we apply the electric field here, so the electron moving here, the hole moving there, okay, because of the apply of the voltage, and then electron diffuse, yeah, diffusivity of hole here, moving to the right, okay, in the same time. Now, yeah, then the we have during on the way, the whole come to the end here, come to the end here, yeah, come to the end here, and then this whole, yeah, this whole, yeah, this whole come to the end, and then at the same time they were recombined with the electron from emitter here. From base here, electron diffused from the base to the end, and then recombine. Yeah, some of them recombine with the hole, yeah, from the emitter. Okay, so this is the recombination, yeah, of the electron hole and end. Yeah, and then some of the electron diffused to the P here. Diffuse to the P, yeah, yeah, to make a electric field, yeah. Remember in the PN junction forward bias, yeah. Remember that one, okay. So, we have actually, yeah, when they cross the junction here, so we this is a current, yeah, current of electron, yeah, from the P move to the P here, and then the at the same time they will have the E a current, yeah, the hole, yeah, to the right, to the right, yeah. So this is, will be we have a current because of a hole, injected hole, and the current because of the moving across of the electron to the P positive, yeah, from N. So then causing the current, yeah, yeah. Remember, yeah, at the PN junction, yeah, yeah, at the equilibrium, that diffusion current will cause the diffusion of electron will cause the drift. Electron. The drift electron, this one is considered as a current, yeah, that considered as a hole, yeah, as a hole. So then moving of electron from N to P, diffusion of electron from N to P, there will be addition current from P positive to N, yeah. So then we have in the here current, we have the IEP, yeah, current flow from P positive to the N, yeah, because of the hole motion from hole injection, yeah, diffusion, yeah, of a hole from P positive to the N, yeah. So we have the IEP. The IEP is a hole, some of them of IEP of a hole will recombine with the electron from diffusion electron from the base, recombine. So then because of the diffusivity, diffusion length of a hole still can move, yeah, can diffuse to the right, to the P, because of N is a narrower. So then we have a this is as we call the IC, yeah. IC here, yeah, is a IEP minus, yeah, minus recombination, yeah, yeah, recombination in N, right. Of course, not only from the IEP and minus recombination, but plus IEN because of the electron diffusion across the junction here, yeah. So make a IEN, this is a IEN, IN, IEP, so we have the IEC, IC, yeah, IC, yeah, okay. So at the same time, yeah, at the same time, in the junction, in the reverse bias, so we have a number three here is a thermally generated electron and hole, yeah, generated electron and hole here, and then they will recombine each other. Yeah, will recombine each other, and there is no current flow here, yeah, because of the excess of hole. Yeah, because of the thermally generated electron. Yeah, so this is very small, and then will not be considered. Yeah, this one, and we consider this is as a zero. Yeah, okay. So this is the working principle of a bipolar junction transistor. So the IEC here can be greater if we inject holes from E, from the P positive to P, from the, and we increase the voltage here. Increasing the voltage, so we will increase the hole injected, increase the hole injected here. And then we can the more injected hole to the C P collector here. Yeah. So then the IC will be increasing. Yeah. So then the we have here as a load. Yeah. So we can energize this load. Okay. Okay, paham the principle of the bipolar junction, yeah, a transistor BJT. Yeah. So this by increasing the injected hole, by increasing the voltage, by increase the injection hole, and then will increase the injected hole in P side of collector, and then will increase the current. Okay, ya, yeah. Sampai di sini, okay. Now, ya, yeah. So this transistor have the characteristic. The characteristic is a dependence of the what kind of semiconductor we use. Yeah. What is the diffusivity? What is the mobility electron in a certain semiconductor, like in silicon or in germanium or in gallium arsenide? They were different. Yeah, we have shown. Yeah, in the previous class. Yeah, so then that make the characteristic of a transistor. The characteristic of a transistor can be as follows. Yeah, so the collector current is made up entirely of those holes injected at the emitter, which are not lost to recombination in the base. Yeah, so I see. Yeah, the current of the collector. Yeah, yeah. So this is a minus. Yeah, recombination hole and electron in the end. Thus, IC is proportional to the whole component of the emitter current IEP. Yeah. So then the we have the IC, a dependence of IP, and the characteristic of this material. And the characteristic of material we call as a base transport factor. Yeah, base transport factor will determine the number of current IC from the IEP, injected the current from the emitter, yeah, or current hole from the emitter. Yeah. So this is IC equal B IEP. Yeah, B is a base transport factor. The total emitter current IE, yeah, IE, this one, yeah. IE is made up of the whole component IEP, yeah, and IEN, IEN, because of the diffusion of electron from N to the P positive. So then, due to the electron injected from the base to the emitter, yeah, this base to the emitter electron, many of them recombine with the hole, and some of them will go to the diffuse to the P positive. So the emitter injection efficiency, that's gamma. We have a emitter injection efficiency, and then we have the base transport factor. Yeah, determine the IEC from the IEP, and then emitter injection factor efficiency is dependence of the IEM, the diffuse to the P positive, yeah, gamma and the beta, gamma and B. And then further, we will have actually ideally, yeah, from the ideal, the ideal one, yeah, IC same with the IEP, so this is a equal one, the ideal one, as well as then gamma. In gamma, there is no, there is no IEN, yeah, yeah. So this, in the gamma, this is also ideally IEP over IEN plus I. So this is the all of this will diffuse to the from the whole from the P positive to the N, yeah. So without any diffusion, without any recombination with the this one. So this is all of we will go to the P collector. Yeah. So gamma one. Yeah. P also one. So then we can see the relationship between collector and the emitter. Current. So we have the alpha. The alpha is a current transfer ratio. We have the current transfer ratio. We have a gamma. We have a beta as well. Yeah. So then the on the other hand, the relation between IC and IB is more promising for amplification. Yeah, for the amplifier. Yeah. So we use the transistor for the amplifier, yeah, amplification. Actually, amplification to double, triple the current. Yeah, flow. Yeah, to the load. So we have if the fraction of injected hole making across the base without recombination is P, then it follows that 1 minus P is the fraction recombining in the base. That's the base current will be this one. And then for the we have we arrange IC over IB. And then this, and then we have the IEP. Yeah, we divide it with the IEN plus IEP. Good. And then we have IC over IB is alpha over 1 minus alpha, or we call as a beta. So this beta related to the collector current, to the base current, is the base to collector current amplification factor. Base to collector current amplification factor, yeah, beta. Okay. Yeah. So this is the we have the example. Yeah. This you can do by yourself. Yeah. For the example. Amplification of the common emitter transistor circuit. Yeah, so this is the original one, and then this is the result. Yeah, this is for the IB. This is the IC. Yeah, the amplifier from C from 0.05 to the 5. Yeah, 0.05 milliampere to the 5 milliampere. So we amplify how many times? 100. Yeah, 100 times. Yeah, so this is the amplification. Okay. Okay, and for the BJT, bipolar junction transistor. Paham? Ada yang tak paham? So you can explore more, yeah, using any reference or watching the recorded video. Okay, so this is the we have studied about the bipolar junction transistor, yeah, the simple transistor. We have now we have a diode, we have a bipolar junction transistor, and then next we have another transistor. Of course, all of these are transistors. All of these are transistors, so you can we can have how to make a different transistor and different control and different input, different output, and then of course this will be useful for the application, yeah, for the developing microprocessor or microchip, yeah. So then nowadays we can see that by miniaturization of the semiconductor devices, so we can many chip into the microprocessor, then we increase the function of the microchip, and then we can make the processing becoming faster and faster that we want, yeah, like by increasing the number of transistor chipping into the micro chip, yeah, and then we increase the function, yeah, of the microprocessor, like from i3, i5, i7, and now i9. And then you see the different, yeah, the different, yeah, from the volume we do not increase the num, we do not increase the size, yeah. The micro the microprocessor, yeah, the size is 1 cm × 1 cm, and the number further of the electronic devices there is not I mean in term of the in term of the weight, for example, and the weight is not increased, but the number of the transistor increase. So this is how the technology having the added value. Yeah, yeah. You know that the microprocessor i5, i7, i9 will be having the different price. Yeah, even the volume is the same. The volume is not to change. Yeah, as 1 cm × 1 cm, but we can add the number of the transistor. At the end, we can add the number of the function of the microprocessor. Yeah, whether we will be increasing the speed. Why increasing the speed? Because the process can be execute parallelly, yeah, so at the parallelly, and then we can get the result quickly, faster. So this is the idea of the miniaturization of the electronic devices. Yeah, later we use the nanotechnology, then we can make how we can fabricate the N and P type. Yeah, and semiconductor. We have studied how can we make it, yeah, in the semiconductor, like a silicon. So by the yeah, by the doping, yeah. So we dope the semiconductor using the thermally doping or using the velocity of energy of the penetration of moving of the dopant into the semiconductor. Okay, if there is no question, so I end this class. Yeah, thank you for attention. So hopefully you can understand about the BJT, yeah, bipolar junction transistor. Okay, I end this class. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam. Thank you, Dr.
Okay. Thank you, Dr.
Thank you, Dr.